Let us now study about amplitude modulation. We can write that an amplitude modulation, amplitude of carrier wave has varied according to the baseband signal. This is what we have discussed in the previous section. Here we can write, if we are having a device that is an AM modulator, in which one a baseband signal is supplied, which is having say displacement in form of YM is equals to AM sine of omega MT, and we give input a carrier wave, which is high frequency, that is YC is equals to AC sine of omega CT. Here omega C we can consider to be very, very greater than the signal which is being modulated. This baseband signal is also called modulating signal. The signal which will modulate the carrier wave when it is imposed on the carrier wave. So, the output of this modulator will be AM signal, or we call it amplitude modulated signal. Here the signal will be YAM, and that will be equals to R sine of omega CT. Because in this situation we are imposing baseband signal onto this carrier wave in form of amplitude only. So, the amplitude modulated signal will have same frequency as that of carrier wave, but the amplitude will be modulated, or it will be modified. So, here we can write amplitude of AM wave is, here this R we can write as when this AC is superimposed over the baseband signal, then this R, the new amplitude of the amplitude modulated signal, this will be AC plus AM sine of omega MT. So, in this situation here we can write AM wave is, here AM wave can be written as YAM is equals to AC plus AM sine of omega MT multiplied by sine of omega CT. This is the equation of an amplitude modulated signal. And here we can see the amplitude of this AM wave varies according to the information in baseband signal, but its frequency is omega C, which is very high. So, this is the frequency which is actually being transmitted. So, it will overcome all the problems because this is a frequency which is much higher than the baseband or modulating signal. Let's continue our analysis on the next sheet. On continuation here, we can analyze this wave equation further, as if we take this AC common, this will be 1 plus AM by AC sine of omega MT multiplied by sine of omega CT. Here this AM by AC we can consider a constant mu. Here mu can be taken as AM by AC, which is called modulation index. And if we substitute it as mu, this YAM can be written as, after opening this, this will be AC sine of omega CT. Plus, this will be taken as mu, and this can be written as mu sin omega MT multiplied by sin omega CT. So, this product of two sine functions can be further split in cosine form, as this can be written as mu AC by 2 cosine of omega C minus omega MT minus mu AC by 2 cosine of omega C plus omega m multiplied by t. Now, in this function here, you can see there are three frequencies. One is omega c, another is omega c minus omega m, and the one is omega c plus omega m. So, here we can write the AM signal, amplitude modulated signal, consist of three frequencies, which are one is omega C, other is omega C minus omega M, and the one is omega C plus omega M. Here, this is the carrier frequency on which we are imposing the baseband signal. And due to imposition of baseband signal, the carrier wave will be having frequency variation from omega C minus omega M to omega C plus omega M. So, this is the lowest frequency in the amplitude modulated signal. This is called lower side frequency. And this is the highest frequency in the amplitude modulated signal, which we call upper side frequency. Now, if we draw the frequency spectrum of amplitude modulated wave or amplitude modulated signal, here you can simply write it with the frequency omega. If we write down the amplitude, then of frequency omega C, the amplitude is directly written as AC, and at the neighboring two side frequencies omega C minus omega M to omega C plus omega M, the amplitude would be, obviously it will be less because this is mu AC by 2, where mu is the modulation index. So, this is the way how we draw the frequency spectrum or how the frequency amplitude variation exists in the amplitude modulated wave. Here, the modulating signal I have taken as AM sin omega MT, whereas in case of normal speech signals, this would be a varying signal with the variety of frequencies in the range of omega M equals to 20 Hz to 20 kHz. So, here the spectrum will be spreaded between the lower side frequency to the higher side frequency, where omega M would be the maximum frequency variation which exists in the modulating signal for the case of speech, or in case of a music or voice signal, here we can take up omega M to be 20 kHz. This is the way how amplitude modulated wave is propagated. But here, as omega M is very less compared to omega C, all these frequencies can be easily transmitted with an antenna which is designed for the frequency omega C, because these are very close to omega C. So, the whole signal containing the baseband signal over the carrier wave can be transmitted and received with the sufficient power. As here, we are changing the amplitude of carrier wave according to baseband signal, that's why it is called amplitude modulation.